नमस्कार, मैं हूं प्रीति। राज्यसभा में जनहित मुद्दों पर होने वाली चर्चाओं पर आधारित कार्यक्रम संसद संवाद के पिछले दो अंकों में हमने फुटवेयर डिजाइन और विकास संस्थान बिल 2017 पर चर्चा देखी थी। परंपरागत चमड़ा उद्योग के आधुनिकीकरण के लिए प्रस्तावित इस बिल से फुटवेयर डिजाइन और विकास संस्थान के 12 कैंपस को राष्ट्रीय महत्व के संस्थान का दर्जा दे दिया गया। इससे इन संस्थानों को अपने छात्रों को डिग्री, डिप्लोमा और सर्टिफिकेट देने का अधिकार मिल गया है। आइए देखते हैं चर्चा का बाकी और आखिरी हिस्सा।
माननीय सभासदों, माननीय उपसभापति जी,
नाउ फुटवेयर डिजाइन एंड डेवलपमेंट इंस्टीट्यूट बिल, श्री एमी राजीव गौड़ा।
थैंक यू डेप्यूटी चेयरमैन सर। Sir, the Footwear Design and Development Institutes were set up as far back as 1986 by the Rajiv Gandhi government. This is way before the National Skill Development Corporation or Skill India set up by the UPA and NDA governments, and is a tribute to the foresight and ability of Sri Rajiv Gandhi to imagine how much work needed to be done to take this particular sector to world-class standards, to build on India's great heritage in terms of leather work and design. And these institutes have been functioning for many, many years across 12 campuses. This time, we are now making them institutes of national importance, and I support that. So there are certain concerns I have with the details of the bill. One, it relates to the functioning in terms of the finances. So far, these institutes have been funded by the central government. In the bill, it appears that it is the institutes are going to have the ability to raise their own resources. And my concern is that, this is a good thing, that institutes will have the ability to go out and raise resources and enhance their endowment funds, etc. But at the same time, the worry is that these will become commercially oriented and will charge an inordinate amount of money to students. So and then this would also give the Commerce Ministry an opportunity to step back its funding for these institutes, and that would not be a good thing. So I would urge the Minister to clarify on what is the pattern expected of these institutes, and how do we ensure that students do not suffer hardship. When we talk of student hardship, my mind goes back to the last day of the previous session, when we were besieged by phone calls and emails from students urging us to pass that bill on that day. It was listed for business, but we did not take it up. We adjourned early because students were worried that their degrees, the exams that they were planning to take, etc., would not be valid as a result of the bill not being passed. Well, this is not a problem that the minister is unaware of. She certainly had given a written reply to this house, pointing out that about 3,600 plus students were affected in multiple batches from 2012 to 2015. Now, the agony of the students is something to be noted, sir. They were not sure whether they were going to get degrees or not, whether their exams were valid or not. They had to approach the Delhi High Court. They had to approach the Supreme Court. What kind of government are we running if we force our students to spend their time in courts engaging lawyers to ensure that they get some valid degree, valid diploma, whatever it is that we promised them when we allowed them to come in and take admission? So that is a matter of grave concern. So this is partly a result of our education bureaucracy. The students, see, across institutes, there is a demand, and there's been a long-standing demand for getting degree status. I used to teach at the Indian Institute of Management, Bangalore, and only now when we pass the IIM's bill will they also be allowed to grant degrees. Until now, they only issue postgraduate diplomas. These diplomas were sufficient because the market accepted them. And even in the case of FDDI, I'm sure that as their website claims that they have 100% placement, the market is certainly accepting the diploma. But students, parents, prospective in-laws all want their people to have degrees. And given that, it is important to ensure that degrees are granted in the correct manner. Unfortunately, the FDDI first went to the Punjab Technological University, then to Mewar University, then to IGNU, in a desperate attempt to try and get some kind of participation, some kind of approval for their degrees. These were struck down by the University Grants Commission. So what I urge the minister to do is to talk to the HRD ministry, the UGC, etc., and find a solution to ensure that this chaos that has been visited on the students with regard to their diplomas and degrees does not continue to worsen, and this issue continues to remain in the courts. I support Vijay Sai Reddy's point that those people who have previously been given, who have graduated from these institutes, that their diplomas be recognized and officially as degrees after the passage of this particular law with retrospective effect. So there's also concern about the actual functioning of these institutes. One, I am not sure where the faculty all come from, what kind of background input is put into the generation of top quality faculty to ensure high quality training for these students in this very, very important, very focused market-focused discipline. There have been complaints that students have had to pay for their own factory visits, that the quality of materials used in their laboratories and in their workshops are not of, that they are of substandard material. So there are all these concerns that have been raised. So while normally I would not be a person who would ever urge the ministry to get mixed up with the autonomy of the institutes, I strongly support autonomy of educational institutions, here I do urge the minister to ensure that the ministry engages, handholds, works intensively with these institutes to ensure that the quality of education and training that is being provided is of the quality that we have promised the students when we admitted them, that these are also, that the teachers are invested in so that they get world-class training and exposure. This has potential for high fashion, high design, for taking Indian heritage to world markets, etc. And so there is a lot that can be done to make this a world-class set of institutions. So finally, I would just urge the minister to take all these actions and to ensure that the student suffering is brought to an end, that the institutions legitimately and fully earn the status of institutions of national importance. With that, I thank you for the opportunity and commend the bill to the House for passage.
Okay, that's all. Ramnath Thakur, your...
Mananiya Upasabhapati Mahoday, aapne footwear design aur vikas sansthan vidhayak 2017 par bolne ka mauka diya, iske liye kritajna hoon. मैं इस विधेयक का समर्थन करता हूं। 12 जगहों पर यह संस्थान काम करेगा, लोकल चर्मकार उद्योगों युवाओं को रोजगार देने का काम करेगा। जब देश में रोजगार बढ़ने की गति धीमी हो गई है, तब ऐसे संस्थाओं की उपयुक्तता है। इस विधेयक से इस इंस्टीट्यूशन को राष्ट्रीय महत्व का दर्जा मिलेगा। भारत सरकार का मानना है कि अभी दुनिया में फुटवेयर मार्केट 198 बिलियन डॉलर का है, जो 2020 तक 220 बिलियन डॉलर हो जाएगा। हम चाहते हैं कि इसे मानव संसाधन की समृद्धि करने की मदद मिलेगी। हमारा सुझाव है कि ऐसे संस्थान खुले जरूर, पर समयबद्ध तरीके से केंद्र शिष्ट केंद्र बन सके, यही मेरा आग्रह है। इन्हीं चंद शब्दों के साथ हम इस विधेयक का समर्थन करते हैं।
थैंक यू वेरी मच। राम गोपाल जी वांट टू से समथिंग।
सीमन, जिस विधेयक पर चर्चा हो रही है और जो इंस्टीट्यूशन बनाने जा रहे हैं, फुटवियर डिजाइन एंड डेवलपमेंट इंस्टीट्यूट नेशनल इम्पोर्टेंस की, उसका महत्व तभी तक है जब उससे ट्रेंड या ट्रेनिंग पाकर निकले हुए लोगों को काम करने को मिले। और वो काम करने को तब मिल सकता है जब लेदर इंडस्ट्री को लेदर उपलब्ध हो। क्या माननीय मंत्री जी को ये एहसास नहीं हो रहा है कि लेदर के अवेलेबिलिटी में दिक्कत आ रही है, कमी नहीं आ रही है? कैटल्स के मूवमेंट पर रोक लग गई है, स्लॉटर हाउसेस बंद हो गए। तो जब लेदर नहीं होगा तो आप ये ट्रेनिंग दे के अनएम्प्लॉयड लोगों को पैदा करती रहिए। पहले जो गलत नीतियां अपनाई जा रही हैं उनको वापस लीजिए, लेदर पर्याप्त मात्रा में उपलब्ध हो, वरना जो बड़े पैमाने पर एक्सपोर्ट होता था जूता चाहे वो और लेदर की चीज़ें आगरा से या और जगह से और दक्षिण में से बहुत ज़्यादा, वो उसमें आपका जो एक्सपोर्ट करने से जो फॉरेन करेंसी मिलती थी उसमें भी कमी आई होगी। अगली बार का जो इकोनॉमिक सर्वे आएगा वो बता देगा कि क्या स्थिति है एक्चुअल। तो ये जो कर रहे हैं आप काम एक तरफ से, ये कंट्राडिक्टरी है, सेल्फ कंट्राडिक्टरी। आपकी पॉलिसीज़ गवर्नमेंट की कुछ ऐसी हैं जो लेदर उपलब्ध ही न हो मार्केट में, और इस तरह के बिल ला के नेशनल इम्पोर्टेंस, तो नेशनल इम्पोर्टेंस माने है कि वहाँ से जो निकलें लोग उनको अच्छा काम कर करने का मौका मिले, अच्छी डिज़ाइन के फुटवियर और अन्य लेदर के जो सामान है उनको बनाने का मौका मिले। लेकिन लेदर ही नहीं, मैं तो आगरा में जानता हूँ सारे लोगों को, धीरे धीरे सब ख़त्म होने जा रहा है, दुकानें सब बंद हो जाएंगी, तो इसको सुधारिए। मैं कोई भाषण देने आया नहीं था, लेकिन जब ये मामला यहाँ देखा तो देखा कि ये मैंने पर्सनली देखा है, और आगरा के जो बड़े बड़े कई लोग हैं मेरे मित्र हैं जिनके ये काम करते हैं, जो एक्सपोर्ट करते हैं बड़े पैमाने पर जूता बनाते हैं, वे खुद एहसास कर रहे हैं कि साहब कुछ दिनों बाद हमारी सब ये फैक्ट्रीज़ बंद हो जाएंगी, तो उसका तो कुछ इलाज कीजिए। वैसे तो ये अच्छा काम आप कर रही हैं, लेकिन जो गलत काम हो रहा है उसको सुधारने की कोशिश कीजिए, ये मेरी आपको सलाह है। धन्यवाद।
रिगार्डिंग रिजर्वेशन ऑफ दिस इंस्टीट्यूट, देयर इज अ प्रोविजन फॉर रिजर्वेशन, बट दैट हैज बीन डेलीगेटेड टू द सेनेट ऑफ दैट इंस्टीट्यूट। So, regarding the percentage of reservation, there is no guidelines in the Act, but the decision to be taken by the concerned Senate of the Institute. As far as Tamil Nadu is concerned, 69% reservation policy is in place, in force. So, we should not be at the mercy of the Senate of the Institute. Okay. So, the central government may issue an order under section or class 33, that providing 69% percentage to the Chennai Institute, Tamil Nadu Institute. I request, very humbly request the Honorable Minister to make a statement, followed by the order providing for 69% to the Chennai Institute.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
CDI today is able to stand up to say that it is an institution of national importance, provided the House approves. It has curriculum strength, it has training strength, it has wonderful faculty, and the international universities and institutions are helping us prepare the curriculum content. It is not just another institution which provides training for students. It is done extremely well.
The story we thought we knew. The story of magnificence. The story of bloody battles. Of those who ruled and those who left their footprints. The story charting the course of our past. Talking History on Rajya Sabha TV.
Now, Minister, please.
Thank you, Deputy Chairman, sir. I'm indeed grateful that the details of the bill have been well taken on board, and every member who spoke has really spoken with a concern that an institution which is imparting skills and is also readying youngsters to be able to get good options entering into the market is being absolutely supported, and I'm very grateful to all the members for having taken a holistic picture on this. I'd just like to give a picture of what exactly are we looking at when we're talking about FTDI. There are 12 campuses, and those 12 campuses are fairly well spread. Although I did get the impression when some members were talking about centers which are in Kolkata or center which is in Chennai, are part of those which are being proposed. Indeed not. Kolkata, Chennai are all fully functional units. So 7 units are already fully functional. And as member Rajiv Gowda said, yes, it was envisaged even in 1986. No doubt on that. But of course, it has gone through quite a difficult phase between 2012 and 2014 November. It is because of the difficulty that the FTDI has gone through between 12 and 14. And we've realized after, in fact, I'm quite thankful to Member Rajiv Gowda to suggest that we should be talking to UGC, you should be talking to HRD. We have done all that. Today we are here, and earlier I'm thankful to the Lok Sabha for having considered the bill and passing it in April 2017. We are here with this Institute of National Importance because after trying all various different sources to see how best FTDI can retain that level, it reached the level which was envisaged in 1986, that it should have that quality and everything else. But unfortunately, during 2012, and I'm not bringing party politics here, but unfortunately, the very party which was envisaging this wonderful FTDI, which has brought in a great deal of expertise and helped the students, could not see the step that they were taking in taking this institute to a standalone university in Rajasthan. I'm not naming the university, it is on the record, all of us have seen it, for a national institution spread over so many states. We've had, unfortunately, by the very government of the party which envisaged this wonderful institution, also taking this step which has brought the students to this state of affairs. 2012, it went over from Indira Gandhi National Open University, open, agreed, but national, to a state-level university which was not authorized to deal with an institution such as FTDI. And therefore, since then, which was recognized by November 2014 by the UGC that it should not have gone to Mewar, it is from then the difficulties of the students became pronounced. And we have, from then, only tried to keep them calm, youngsters, uncertain about their degrees, not knowing what to do, obviously went to the court, nothing wrong, because they were all put to great uncertainties and difficulties. But didn't know what to do because it was an institution run by the Commerce Ministry. It was being run by the Commerce Ministry. So the government running institution has led to an uncertainty which is not justifiable. Yes, I agree, it was not justifiable. And I was a bit hurt when Sri Rajiv Gowda said, what kind of a government are we running? I'm sorry, I will stand up here to say, honorable member, we are running a responsible government. And that is why between 2014 till today, we've gone from pillar to post to say how best we can correct that error. The error which was committed in 2012 by taking this institution to a private, single, freestanding university confined to a state and not a national university, not an approved university, who had no business to deal with the nationally spread institutions. That mistake of 2012, whilst I recognize the visionary thing done in 86, I also do have to put on record that there was an error committed in 2012, and it is after Modiji's government that we've taken all the steps to ensure that the students get justice. And therefore, with that said, I would want to address the importance of such an institute, which was well conceived in 86, very well thought out in 86, no doubt. It's a particular sector which has intense labor potential. Skilled labor is required, and you have started doing very good skilling through this institution, which was spread in 7 areas, and now 5 more are also getting operational. That skilling has given them excellent jobs on the campus. And that on the campus jobs are the main attraction even for children coming from middle class and lower middle class families saying, it is expensive, but we are glad to put our children through this, because at the end of the day, in the campus, they get recruited for good jobs. And to just ensure and let you know that the FTDI today is able to stand up to say that it is an institution of national importance, provided the House approves. It has curriculum strength. It has training strength. It has wonderful faculty. And the kind of international institutions which are helping us develop the content for these courses. I would just like to draw the attention of the members. Northampton University from the UK, ARSUTORIA, Arts Tutoria from Italy, Thomas Bata University from the Czechoslovakia formerly, now Czech Republic, PFI from Germany, LDI from Germany, SATRA from UK. All these international universities and institutions are helping us prepare the curriculum content. It is not just another institution which provides training for students. It is done extremely well, but those 2 years have added to the confusion, and unfortunately because of that, a certain suspicion that its brand image will get affected really came in the minds of the students and all of us too. And therefore, I just want to assure and draw the attention of the House that in order to restore it to the position in which it was, and even probably improve it in the near future, we have chosen to go through the route of seeking members of the House to support us in making it an institution of national importance. 2,700 students are currently pursuing the degree program in the campuses, and the maximum capacity, including the 5 new campuses, is going to be 8,900. So, just imagine we are touching, almost going to touch 10,000 in their capacity. It certainly will benefit the socially weaker sections, because the provisions are such that once they finish the degree, they would be able to set up their own enterprises. I think there was a member who spoke about what is the use if you're only training 1 lakh members, 1 lakh students. No, not at all. It's far higher than that. Nearly 4 lakh students, 4.0 lakh unemployed youth have been, particularly from the weaker sections, have been trained between 2009 and 2016. I would want to put that on record. And out of these, 3.27 lakh have been placed in various footwear companies for the first time. And FDDI trained more than 1 lakh. Besides this number, we have trained 1,45,164 trainees, against a target of 1,44,000, slightly exceeded number, during 2016-17 alone. And this is normally through the operator training centers, which we have nearly in 15 states, aside from the 7+5 institutions, 7 of which are running, 5 which will be running sooner. In addition, that is total of 12. So the operation training centers, which are in 15 states, have nearly 96 centers within the 15 states, 96 operating centers, and they are the ones who are training these people. Again, a similar target to train 1,45,000 students for the year 2017-18 has been established. And we are sure to complete that target too. There were specific references made by several members to which I wish to answer. Need to have centers opened in states like Jharkhand and Chhattisgarh. I definitely do recognize the need. I'm also going to have to put on record here, the Chief Minister of Jharkhand has been very keen that an FTDI come over to his state too, just as many members have asked for their states. I would have to progressively spread it, but at the moment, the process is only for the 7+5 till after this act is getting passed. Why not in Kanpur? I would want to just highlight here that Kanpur has indeed an operational training center for imparting skills under the skill development program of the FDDI. FDDI institution may not be present in Kanpur, but Kanpur does have an operator training center. The skill is suitable for requirement of the entire leather industry, so Kanpur is being covered in a way. Honorable Member Sahasrabuddhe raised issues as to why should institutions be spread in different ministries, why can't there be some cohesion in that. I would just like to draw his attention. The leather sector needs definite specific focus for development, which will be lost, and that's not to say anything less about the HRD, but that will be lost in the pool of universities that you have under HRD, which are being run and guided by the UGC and the Ministry of HRD. We are, from the Commerce Ministry, trying to upscale the process, and the 12 centers will be upgraded with state-of-art equipments and facilities. Entrepreneurship development is going to be taken care of through interaction with industry, which is far more possible because the Department of Industrial Policy is also within the ministry. We expect the industry cooperation also to be part of this. And traditional skills, which is also a point raised by many other members, will not be lost because these operational training centers will certify, and they at the moment do too, certifying of people who come from weaker sections with particular skills, and therefore we are not being exclusive. On the contrary, we are being inclusive. That's something which I'd like to highlight here. Member Vijay Sai Reddy did raise the question whether it will be applicable in retrospect. I'd like to tell the member that it is already provided for under the Section 37C of the Act, of the bill which is now present before this House. It covers students enrolled, if you're specifically asking about those students who've been put to difficulty, it covers students enrolled after 2012 too. So it naturally covers that section of the students who are at the moment left in a limbo. I suppose majority of the questions raised by the different members have been addressed on the reservation policy. I would like to assure the members there's nothing for anyone to worry about it. All the extant policies of the government regarding reservation will be good, which are with central government approved policies. So there's nothing to worry about reservation policy. You can be assured that we are taking care of that as well. I suppose with this, okay. I've very clearly addressed the issues broadly raised by all the members. Coming specific to the repeated line that, which I think I will capture in the words of Professor Ram Gopal Yadavji. He said it in so many different words. जब लेदर मिलना ही मुश्किल है, गलत नीति अपना रहे हैं, उसको सही करो। और in his interaction with many of the units in Agra, he says many of them have told him that उनके अपने कारोबार खत्म होने जा रहे हैं, गलत काम जो उधर हो रही है उसको सुधारो। मैं प्रोफेसर राम गोपाल यादव जी को ज़रूर भरोसा दे दिलाना चाह रही हूँ गलत नीति जो था पहले उसको सही करवाने के लिए ही हम कोशिश कर रहे हैं जो गलत नीति था उसके तहत अनरेगुलेटेड अनलाइसेंस्ड इलीगल जगह से लेदर मिलता था वो सही नहीं है आप भी नहीं मानेंगे वो सही है इसीलिए इसको रेगुलेट करने का कोशिश हो रही है ये कोशिश नहीं हो रही है कि लेदर को बंद ही करो हम बोल रहे हैं कि जो नीति के तहत जो एक्सटेंट नीति के तहत होना है वो होने देना बस उसको
आए हैं उनको भी बंद कर दिया गया है पता कर लीजिए उत्तर प्रदेश में
लीगल सेंटर्स ऑथराइज्ड सेंटर्स से जो काम हो रही है उसको रोकने के लिए कोई कोशिश नहीं हो रही है मगर अगर इलीगल क्षेत्र से वही लेदर को मिलने के लिए कुछ कोशिश हो रही है, उसको तो रेगुलेट करना आवश्यक, आप भी मानेंगे। उतना ही हो रही है, लेदर सप्लाई भी होना मगर रेगुलेटेड होना, ऑथराइज्ड होना, ट्रेनिंग भी होना, क्योंकि हमारे लिए ट्रेनिंग शिक्षा पाए हुए युवा की आवश्यकता है, उनके लिए हम मेहनत भी कर रहे हैं। इस आश्वासन के साथ डिप्टी चेयर, आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट द हाउस टू कंसिडर पासिंग दिस बिल। थैंक यू वेरी मच।
सभी सांसदों ने माना कि ये विधेयक चर्मोद्योग से जुड़े मानव संसाधन को बेहतर बनाने में मदद करेगा। चर्चा के दौरान कई सांसदों ने फुटवेयर डिजाइन और विकास संस्थान को अपने राज्यों में खोले जाने की मांग की, तो कई सांसदों ने इसकी क्षमता को बढ़ाने की भी सलाह दी। तत्कालीन वाणिज्य और उद्योग मंत्री निर्मला सीतारमन ने चर्चा के दौरान कहा कि संस्थान के देश में चल रहे 7 कैंपस समेत 12 कैंपस स्थापित किए जाएंगे। इस विधेयक से इन्हें राष्ट्रीय महत्व का संस्थान घोषित किया जाएगा। इस कानून का मकसद युवाओं को फुटवेयर उद्योग का अंतर्राष्ट्रीय स्तर का प्रशिक्षण संस्थान तैयार करना है। फिलहाल संसद संवाद के इस अंक में इतना ही। नमस्कार।
We'll be right back.